Queensland Police. May I start with your first and last name, please?
My name's Jake. I'm a client service operator at PoliceLink. PoliceLink essentially is a non-agent contact centre for the entire state of Queensland. So we take all kinds of police inquiries and police contacts from members of the public. They have a matter that's happening now that requires the police, they'll call 000. If it's a matter that's happened and it's after the fact, they'll call us. People will call us with inquiries for anything. Like, we will take inquiries from just general inquiries about what the police do, about speeding tickets, right up to very complex things that we need specialist police advice for. I guess my expectations about the role, I didn't really have any coming in, and I kind of expected to be on the phone, but I didn't really expect to be doing the amount of things that I was doing here. It was a nice change of pace, and it was really something I wanted to do. You get a lot of training here. I think that at this point in time, it's 26 weeks to train a police officer and it's 20 weeks to train a CSO. It's two 10-week blocks. So there's a 10-week block of training where you learn all about what we do here. And then there's a 10-week transition block where you have a one-on-one mentor that helps you with the phone call. You go from literally zero to knowing everything that the police do in just a short time period. The most challenging thing about this role is that at the end of the day, you do have to remember that we work for a policing organisation, and we do have to deal with calls that are quite difficult in nature. Sometimes it's hard because you don't get the resolution on the other end of the phone. You can't dwell on it, you can't take it home, and it can be a bit of a challenge sometimes. In terms of work-life balance and shift work, it's like any shift job, I guess, but PoliceLink is a 24/7 contact center. The most rewarding thing about this job is having the opportunity to give some solutions or a resolution to someone. People will call when they're having essentially the worst day of their life. We need to be able to provide that support to them to say, at the end of that call, I'm gonna get you some assistance. I think to be suitable for this role, essentially, all you need to have is good communication, computer skills, and a good sense of patience and a really good sense of empathy. If I had to tell someone that was thinking about applying, I would definitely say do it. Anyone can do this job. There's young and old. It doesn't matter where you're from or who you are. You get trained at the start, and then as you go on, you'll become a better and better CSO. It's a really rewarding career, and it's a really great thing to do. It's a really good way to service the community.